So we talk about the outlines of national cybersecurity. So what cybersecurity is say that one single vulnerability is that all an attacker needs. So when cybersecurity, cyber technology becomes a key variable in the defense policies of a nation, land size and GDP size are irrelevant. National security concept in the two decades of the 21st century has undergone fundamental change. And these fundamental changes reveal that large size of the country, large country in terms of geography, population and GDP will not deter any country. So even the capacity to cause devastation using the cyber technology, using the cyber warfare is within the reach of even a smaller and poorer nation. So capacity to cause devastation by the cyber warfare is within the reach of even a smaller and poorer nation. So innovation in the weapon moved from stones in the prehistoric era to bows and arrow, from stone to bows and arrow. And in the later cannons and guns in the 19th century, this was followed by aeroplanes, nuclear bombs and intercontinental missile in the 21st century. In 21st century, the world is moving to the cyber warfare, cyber weapons based warfare. So in the 21st century, the world is moving to the cyber weapon based warfare. So now will the size of the country will cease to matter. So even a small island country will have capacity to cause devastation by cyber warfare. Our capacity to cause devastation by cyber warfare is within the reach of even a smaller and poorer nation. So the smaller nation have the capability to cause unacceptable damage. More innovation are happening. The fundamental changes are entirely due to the earlier 21st century innovation in the cyber technology and software development. So fundamental change is due to the innovation in the cyber technology and software development. Drones, robots and satellites. So drones, for example, Azerbaijan and Armenia ke beech mein kya use hua tha? Drones use hue the. Drones, robots and satellites and advanced computer as a weapon already in use. So drones, robots and satellite and advanced computers are as weapons already in use. And further innovations are artificial intelligence in the field of nanotechnology. So cyber warfare, so from a remote control drones to artificial intelligence drive weapon system. So cyber warfare, in the case of cyber warfare, you can operate it from a remote control drones. For example, Israel killed Iran's nuclear scientist by artificial intelligence assisted remote control killing machine. For example, Israel attacked Iranian scientist by artificial intelligence assisted remote control killing machine. So the person name is, the Iranian scientist is Mohsin. Mohsin Fakhrizadeh. So he was killed by artificial assisted killing machine. So we have seen from remote control drones to a artificial assisted driving to the artificial intelligence driven weapon system. For example, Israel kill Iranian scientist through the help of artificial assisted driven weapon system. So it was an artificial assisted killing machine. It is Mohsin Fakhrizadeh. So now the national security in the 21st century do not only covers merely overt and covert operation. So national security in the 21st century covered not merely the overt and overt operations, more crucially electronic operations from a remote center beyond the front lines of the guard force. So it is beyond the front line of the guard force. So the operation are electronic in nature and they're controlled from a remote centered. So they are from a remote center beyond the front line of the security guard. Tracking these cyber security warfare of the adversary will need a new national cyber security policy. So tracking these cyber security warfare will need a new cyber security policy. So we need a new cyber security policy. Cyber technology to shut down Mumbai electric supply. So China used cyber technology to shut down Mumbai electric supply for few hours. And the each nation will have to prepare more for bilateral conflicts in the 21st century. So we have to prepare for bilateral conflicts in the 21st century that are based on cyber warfare. So countries will have to prepare for the bilateral conflicts in the 21st century that is based on cyber warfare rather than in multilateral acts of conventional warfare that rely on military works for mobilization. For example, Quad. Quad is a multilateral act. So we have to. So each nation will have to prepare more for the bilateral conflicts in the 21st century that are based on cyber warfare rather than the multilateral acts of conventional warfare that rely on the military blocks for mobilization. So, the national security of policy of 21st century is to define what assets are required to be defended, the identity of the opponents who seek to overrun the people of the target nation. So, although the novel coronavirus is perhaps accidental, it is completely destabilize the people globally. So, what should be the priorities? The national security priority will require new department for supporting the frontiers of innovation. So, there should be new department that will support frontiers of innovation and technologies such as hydrogen fuel cell. So, what are the new technology can be used? Hydrogen fuel cells, desalination of seawater, thorium for nuclear technology, anti-computer viruses, and new immunity creating medicine. And new immunity creating medicine, the focus on the new priority will require compulsory science and mathematics education. So, the focus on new priority will require compulsory science and mathematics education. So, if we talk about the strategy, for this new national security policy will be to anticipate our enemies. So, our strategy will be for this national security is to anticipate our enemies in many dimensions and demonstrate and we need limited preemptive strike by developing a strategy of deterrence of the enemy. We need a limited preemptive strike by developing a strategy of deterrence. We'll develop a deterrence if we have a capability of preemptive strike. For India, it will be the China cyber capability. So, China has a huge cyber capability factor, which is a new threat for which it has to devise new strategy. India needs to devise new strategy as a China because of the China cyber capability. India, by trying to be friend nation on the both side, are divided. India trying to be friend nation on the both sides, for example, like Russia, USA of the divide, ended up with no serious ally internationally. So, we must know that increased use of technology in the cyber warfare has made the aspect of geography, population, GDP, size of GDP are relevant. So, there is a innovation in the 21st century in the artificial intelligence, 5G, nanotechnology. So, we need a new cyber security policy. So, what should be the four dimensions of the national security policy of 21st century? What should be the objective? What should be the priority, strategy and resource mobilization? So, cyber warfare can be used by nation state and non-state actors. So, cyber warfare, so the help of cyber warfare, they are capable of causing infrastructure damage. For example, China used cyber technology to shut down the Mumbai electric supply for hours. So, capable of causing infrastructure damage, leak of data. So, there will be leak of data because threat to national security, commercialization for personal details, for example, health and financial data, disrupt critical information system, disrupt election, for example, internet-based voting, and influence the voters. So, what should be our objective? That first of all, we'll have to identify the asset that need to be defended. We should know the identity of the perpetrators and preparing for the future disruptive events. We must have a capability of preemptive strike. So, the new department should be created that support innovation and research and developing technologies like hydrogen fuel cell, desalination, seawater, thorium and nuclear technology, anti-computer viruses and medicines for immunity. So, what are our priorities? So, we must have national security priorities of the 21st century will require new department for supporting several frontiers of innovation technologies, such as hydrogen fuel cell, desalination of seawater, thorium for nuclear technology, anti-computer viruses and new immunity creating vaccine. And the focus of new priority will require compulsory science and mathematics education. So, China cyber capability factor, it made it compulsory that we need new cyber security policy. And in order to resource mobilization, we need to strengthen our economy so that sufficient resources are available for the foolproof cyber security policy. So, what can be the conclusion? That everybody should make sure that we have cyber tools necessary to investigate the cyber crimes and to be prepared to defend against them. So, we must have capability to defend the cyber crime, and we have necessary tool to investigate the cyber crime and to bring the people to justice who committed. So India has to create a deterrent. India should have must have a capability to cause unacceptable damage on the attacking country. So that a country before attacking India must think 1,000 times. So country before attacking India must think 1,000 times. For that we must have a deterrent. We must have a capability to cause unacceptable damage on the attacking country. So Israel has become a world leader in the cyber technology. So Israel has become one of the top five cyber security partners in the world. Israel received more venture capital fund than per person than any other country in the world. It has known as a startup nation. So Israel is practically surrounded by the nation that you cannot cross. So that's why Israel has developed creativity to compensate for its lack of resources. So Israel developed creativity to compensate for its lack of resources. So Israel is a country that conducts constant surveillance on the neighbors as a country which is under constant annihilation threat by the other nation. So it's constant annihilation threat by the other nation. So you talk about the wars, and launching massive military operation bears almost unbearable prices. So First in the human lives and economic cost in the terms of and economic cost, human lives, economic stress, as well as international legitimacy. So cyber warfare is the right answer. So military service is mandatory for almost all the Israeli citizens. So 2030 Ministry of Defense in Israel create a national cyber program for high school students. So create a national cyber program for high school student interested in learning about the cyber warfare. So national program for high school student. In 2030, Defense Ministry has created a national program for high school student interested in learning about the realm of the cyber security. So there's a Ken David Hotel in Israel, considered to the world's safest hotel in the world. So the King David Hotel in Israel, considered the safest place on the earth.
So it is resistant to bomb explosion and chemical attacks. The world's safest hotel in Jerusalem, Israel. So King David Hotel in Israel, in Jerusalem. So Gaza-Israel barrier is border is constructed by Israel. The Gaza-Israel barrier border is constructed by Israel on the Israeli side of Gaza-Israel border.
So Israel has a robot army, and that is designed to be deployed in many battle situations.
So robots are semi-autonomous and has ability to perform some of the operation on its own. So it can be guided by humans remotely through electronic controller.
So पहले क्या करते हैं, problem को identify करते हैं, फिर उसका solution create करते हैं, फिर deliver करते हैं उसको, और फिर पूरे world में बेचते हैं. तो ICDS. तो identify, create, deliver and sell. तो Israel spend 4% of GDP in research and development. And every 10,000 पे यहाँ पे 120 research scientist है. So there's a 120 research scientist in a population of 10,000 in Israel. So there's a research scientist number 120 in a population of 10,000. So Israel spend on an R&D center, in academic center and laboratories to develop manpower and create a lot of research and development scientists. So India spend only 0.65% of GDP on research and development.
तो छोटी सी कोस्ट लाइन पर भी इसराइल ने बहुत सारे टूरिस्ट बीच बना दिए हैं. तो बहुत ज़्यादा टूरिज्म पोटेंशियल है.
सो तेल अवीव विद 10 किलोमीटर ऑफ कोस्ट लाइन अलॉन्ग द मेडिटेरेनियन सी हैज़ सम ऑफ द बेस्ट बीचेस इन इसराइल. सो सिंस 1966 12 इसराइलीज हैज अवार्डेड द नोबेल प्राइज, 3 पीस, 1 लिटरेचर एंड 8 साइंस. एंड 1968 अरब्स हैव बीन अवार्डेड नोबेल प्राइज, 6 पीस, 1 लिटरेचर, 1 साइंस, ओनली 1 नोबेल प्राइज इन साइंस. एंड इसराइलीज हैव गॉट 8 नोबेल प्राइज इन साइंस. इसराइल हैज़ अ मोर नोबेल प्राइज पर कैपिटा, तो इट हैज मोर नोबेल प्राइज कैपिटा दैन यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, फ्रांस एंड जर्मनी. सो देर आर अराउंड 6,000 स्टार्टअप करेंटली इन इसराइल, एंड इज़ वन ऑफ द लीडिंग कंट्री इन फाइलिंग पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन. सो एटीट्यूड ऑफ अरब्स एंड इसराइलीज आर डिफरेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इसराइली चाइल्ड वॉन्ट टू बिकम लाइक अल्बर्ट आइंस्टीन, नील बोर एंड जॉन वॉन न्यूमैन. ऑन द अदर हैंड अरब वॉन्ट टू बी सलाहुद्दीन अयूबी.
सो देयर वॉज अ फर्स्ट मैसिव साइबर अटैक, चाइना टारगेट इसराइल. तो चाइना लिंक्ड हैकर्स यूज VPN फ्लॉस टू टारगेट US डिफेंस इंडस्ट्री रिसर्चर्स. तो चाइना ऑल्सो टारगेटेड US डिफेंस इंडस्ट्री रिसर्चर्स.
So there is a China hacker army, personal. So there may be 50,000 to 1 lakh individual, China's hacker army. So Foreign Policy magazine provided an estimate range of China's hacker army personnel anywhere from 50,000 to 1 lakh personnel. So in 2010, Chinese hacked PMO computers, PM Manmohan Singh computer. It was confirmed by the then National Security Advisor M.K. Narayanan. So it was confirmed by the then National Security Advisor M.K. Narayanan. So this time Chinese attacked Israel and China masqueraded as Iranian hackers. So masquerade means to behaving hide the truth of somebody. So masquerade. So two people masquerading as doctors. So China masqueraded as Iranian hackers, attack Israeli government institutions. So they detected espionage groups. The name is UNC 215 and they use custom malware tools like FocusJAWD and HyperBro. So and Israel attacked Natanz nuclear facilities in April 2021, and even Natanz suffered a mysterious explosion in 2020. So now Iran is rebuilding that facility deep inside a nearby mountain. So only cyber security, cyber warfare is only the option left with Israel. So Mossad was behind the cyber attack against the Iran's Natanz nuclear facilities. So even Natanz nuclear facility of Iran has been targeted by sabotage in the past, like Stuxnet computer virus in 2010. That was a US-Israeli creation. The Natanz nuclear facilities. So how the Israeli lead the world in cyber security expertise? Because Israel respects its human capital and it has invested in its people on their ambition, skills and expertise to make them technologically empowered, to respect its human capital. So Israel respects its human capital and it has invested in its people on their ambition, skill and expertise to make them technologically empowered. So this is the primary aspect of cyber defense platform. So there is a plethora of the private sector and government programs to drive the Israeli nationalist channel to particular academic pursuits. So the cyber security is given so much importance, so much prominence in Israel that the cyber security education start in the middle school in Israel. So it starts in middle school in Israel. So 2010, Tel Aviv University online cyber security course ranked one in the world. And the Israeli school ranked among the top cyber research. So at the school level, they start the cyber security course. So they start cyber security course at the school level. So Israel was the first country in the history to have a PhD program in cyber security. In modern day Israel, there is a 6th research center dedicated to the cyber security. So there should be more research center dedicated to the cyber security. So cyber security education started in the middle school. Israel is the only country in the world which cybersecurity is elective in the high school matriculation exam. So Isaac Ben Israel, who is the main person behind this, behind making Israel a cybersecurity tech. So no matter from what discipline they are, except the arts, they can specialize anybody, no matter in what discipline they study, except for the arts, they can specialize in cybersecurity. So Israel then, the best cybersecurity is recruited by the Mossad, and it is directly answerable directly to the Prime Minister. India rank is very low in the cybersecurity powers. Most comprehensive cybersecurity power, National Cybersecurity Power Index 2020. India's rank is very low as compared to Israel. Rank is around 11. So India can learn from Israel. USA rank one in the most comprehensive cyber powers. So National Cybersecurity Power Index is published by the Balfour Center of the Harvard Kennedy School, USA. When it comes to cyber power, India fares far behind. Fair means the amount of money that is required to pay. So to be not successful in a particular situation, how did you fare in your examination? So in the same way, when it comes to cyber power, India fares far behind. India is not successful